Rouse's is proud of the creativity and the unparalleled entertainment in New Orleans, and honored to highlight it with their sponsorship of Steppin' Out on WYES.
Peggy Scott Laborde, and welcome to Steppin' Out, with updates from the local restaurant, arts, and entertainment scenes. Joining me, Poppy Tucker, host of Louisiana Eats on WWNO Radio. Hey, Poppy.
Hey, Peggy.
Hello, my dear. It's great to see him back. John Kemp.
Hey, Poppy.
Art columnist for Louisiana Life Magazine and a contributor to Steppin' Out for almost 35 years. It's great to have you back.
Yeah, it's great,
John,
to be back.
Hello. Doug MacCash, who covers the arts and culture scenes for the Times Picayune, the New Orleans Advocate. Hello, sir.
Hey, how are you?
And Alan Smason of theatercriticism.com and the Crescent City Jewish News. We have two white suits today. Good to see you all. Poppy, the location of this restaurant has hosted many eateries, but it looks like this one will stay put, hopefully.
I have been a fan of this location since it was Booty Street Food. And, of course, we're talking about the corner of Dauphine and Louisa down in the Bywater. And I want to tell you what, that Melissa Arroyo, who is really a chef to watch, I've been following her since 2013, and she finally got her bricks and mortar spot open at the start of this year. It's called Alma, and it's fabulous. It's lunch, and it's breakfast and lunch. And so all I can tell you is I went and I wanted to stay through lunch. I waited 2 days to go back. But so for breakfast, and look how charming the place is. It is the way she has decorated it. It's very friendly. It's warm. It's comfortable. I love it in there. And so the breakfast, holy moly, bolitas, Senchila, which are eggs, refried beans, and avocado with some homemade crema on a homemade tortilla. All the tortillas are made fresh there. There's breakfast tacos, not like any you've ever had. Open face with roasted poblano, pepper jack cheese, and crispy potatoes. The tortilla española was something I'd never had before. That was a baked egg turnover is how they describe it. It's kind of like a tart with potatoes, Spanish herbs, crema, and spring mix. That's delicious. And there's seafood choices, too. There's the Louisa toast, which is crab and soft scrambled egg, mushrooms, and herbs. You can also have something very similar as an omelet with crab or shrimp. And then comes lunchtime. That is the Platano Maduro. I never ate anything like this before. It's a baked sweet plantain with refried pintos, crema, and queso fresca. There's exquisite little meat pies. Those pastry on those were fantastic. And the enchiladas, what a surprise they were. The enchiladas Honduras, again, not like anything you've ever had before. Don't expect it to be enchiladas you've ever known. Fabulous, though. And Polo Brasa, their grilled chicken, all of their grilled dishes are great. They're closed. Now, here's the bad news. Now that you're salivating and dying to go, go this weekend, or you're going to have to wait until a week from today, because they're closed Monday through Thursday, actually, until next Friday, for vacation, I discovered. But normally they're there every day except Tuesday, 8 a.m. to 3 p.m., and then Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, there's happy hour from 4 until 7 with things like chicharrones, tuna tartare. Really go to Alma. You're going to love it.
Thank you so much, Poppy. And moving over to John, art news from Waveland.
Yes, big art news from Waveland. Well, first of all, it's called Studio Waveland Plus Gallery. There's a great backstory behind it. But first of all, it's the home, this new home for two very professional, outstanding New Orleans artists who are now Gulf Coast artists. That's Mitchell Gaudet and Erica Larkin Gaudet. They're a remarkable couple. But in 2018, they opened this fabulous new gallery in Waveland in what was supposed to be a revitalization for the whole Waveland area after Hurricane Katrina. FEMA built the building, financed the building as a sort of an economic incubator for the area. And now that building is really the only building in the entire area of Waveland near the Gulf Coast. And so Erica and Mitchell have moved in. They've moved their studios there. And they're doing a wonderful job in bringing in very large art shows to the area. And in a few minutes, I'll talk about one specifically that just recently opened. But they're really rejuvenated that area. And the whole city is hoping this will be sort of an incubator to rejuvenate the whole Waveland area. Now, Erica and Mitchell are really great at sort of neighborhood revitalization. You might recall that back in the early 90s, they did the same thing down in the Bywater section of 3,000 block of Royal Street, where he bought an old factory building and converted that to his new studio Inferno and subdivided the place and rented it out to other artists. Then around 2010, 2013, he moved the whole operation to Araby, did the same thing there, bought an old theater, an old movie house there, and then renovated several buildings in that area and rented out as studios for local artists. Now he's doing that in Waveland, and it's turning out really well. It's a terrific place, and he's bringing in some really great shows.
Which we'll show you in just a few minutes.
Yes, we will.
Exciting news. They're really,
it really is.
They're not afraid to try something new. That takes a lot of courage, especially in the art realm, doesn't it?
Well, you know, not only are they really fine artists, and we were talking about this earlier, not only are they fine artists, but they're really entrepreneurs. They, you know, Mitchell has some Midas touch when it comes to this sort of thing. He did extremely well in the Bywater section and kind of helping that area within the arts, and then also in Araby. But he has this great touch where he just does not only beautiful artwork, but whatever he does it really first rate. And this gallery is a great example of that.
Okay. Well, thank you, John. I'll be back to you shortly.
Okay.
And over to Doug with an exhibit that I have to say can easily make you smile.
It's a good one. This is a great new young artist in town. His name is Christian Dinh. He's a first-generation American. As he told me, his mom and dad came from Vietnam when they were just kids, you know, in the wake of the war in Vietnam in the 1970s. And he admits, Christian admits, that he didn't want to be identified with the sort of perceived stereotypes of the Vietnamese community. The nail salons, the cuisine, the karaoke parties, the Catholic Church. And he also didn't want to be lumped in with all the other Asian cultures either. He wanted to remain an individual. But then somewhere along the line, he had a change of heart. He realized that those things that he felt were cliches might really be cultural triumphs, that the things that kept the community together and allowed cohesiveness. So in his art, he expressed his new devotion to his culture by mixing popular culture, popular images, with the finest craft, finest ceramic craft. Notice the nail polish bottle motif that you'll see again and again in his work. And the hands that are ceramic, but they're based on plastic hands used to advertise manicures. And they're rendered as precious ceramic sculpture, thereby giving them the importance that they deserve. One of the great things in there is notice the fine Chinese style vases that he sort of coyly makes in the shape of fingernail polished bottles.
Yeah, very, very clever. Yes, and this is at the Ogden.
It's at the Ogden. Go upstairs to the fourth floor and head back towards Camp Street. It's a very small exhibit, but worth finding.
Now, you said he had he is actually going to be at a gallery on Royal Street. So stay tuned for more of that.
I just heard, and Peggy, forgive me, I've forgotten the name of the gallery.
That's okay. We'll get it next time.
There's a gallery on Royal Street that has he's going to start showing there, so you'll be able to see his work there as well.
I bet you can check his Facebook page. There's a really good chance. Okay. Thank you so much, Doug. And moving over to Alan.
He looks like a very polished artist.
That's right.
Anyway, so the very good news, Peggy, about theater is that Actors Equity Association, the union, if you will, for 51,000 actors nationwide, has come out with a new set of revised guidelines for COVID. You know, last week we announced that. Now they've come out with new guidelines which will allow local producers, local theaters, to actually hire actors who are equity candidates or also equity members. This is really important because these contracts allow equity actors to be able to be on the local stages. Without those contracts in place, we have problems. And some of our very, very best of acting skills, you know, are people who are in the union. So we really want to commend them for doing this. They've had several different groups, you know, for Lort theaters and for other regional theaters. So they've got three different revised guidelines which will allow more actors to be hired, and we're looking forward to that. Speaking of Actors Equity, you can see behind me is Summer Lyric Theater at Tulane. Well, that's one company that is working with Equity this year. Their 50th anniversary production of Jesus Christ Superstar is about to be unveiled. That'll be running over the course of 2 weekends. And what makes this Superstar so different is the casting. In the original Superstar, Judas was black and Jesus and Mary Magdalene were white. Well, that's reversed in this version, with Prentice E. Mouton on the left there and Chase Kamada as Mary Magdalene. Of course, Prentice is Jesus. And then Alex Stone is Judas. Also, the role of Herod, normally played by a man, will be played by a very talented lady, Jessica Mixon. And I am really certain that Michael McKelvey and Polanco Jones, who are co-directors, and Diane Lala as a choreographer, will make this an amazing full production. This will be the very first full production in Orleans Parish since the epidemic started, the pandemic, whatever you want to call it. Sadly, this will also be Michael McKelvey's final production in New Orleans. He announced this past week his decision to move to Durango, Colorado, to head up a new musical theater department at Fort Lewis College, and we, of course, all wish him very well. Meanwhile, I wanted to go on and talk about something we talked about when he was here, but Lair's lyricisms with, of course, the wonderful personage of Phil Melanson, the talented pianist, keyboard player, etc. He is going to be on stage, if you will, at the Britannia Canal Place Theater, and he's going to be joined by some very, really interesting players. Among them, of course, you've got Bremner Duthie and Claudia Baumgarten, and also Alfred Richard, who some of us may also recall as being on there. I wanted to mention that. But I think I'm out of. I think the printer got out of sequence. So let me go. Let me jump on this.
Well, that's okay. Yeah. You can move on. But just a reminder, that is at Canal Place, the Britannia.
Right.
At Canal
Place.
So
let's go on. Let's move on to Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. This is the other second Andrew Lloyd Webber, Tim Rice piece that's going to be done. And of course, this one is the Old Testament, not the New Testament. And essentially. I should tell you that you've got Ricky Graham as Jacob. You've got a number of people there who are performing, who are really doing a great job in terms of getting the work out at Rivertown Theaters of Performing Arts. You can see a lot of very talented people on stage. Again, this is going to be on for several weekends, and then they're going to have two different shows on Sundays at 1 o'clock and also at 7:30. So keep in mind, a Sunday matinee will be an hour earlier and then a little bit later than the Sunday matinees you used to have at 6 o'clock. It's going to be at 7:30. So that'll be at Rivertown Theaters, and we're looking forward to seeing that as well.
Okay, and then I know you wanted to quickly mention Freedom, the Stage Door Canteen.
Yeah, huh? I'm sorry, the several pages are missing in my script today. Freedom is going to be starting. This is a group that we had. They're starting actually their performances tomorrow night at the National World War II Museum's Stage Door Canteen. And again, you've got Sean Patterson, of course, the director, and the two people there, Lorraine LeBlanc and Todd Voltz,
are going to be the two characters who are going to be on stage. And again, this is a work of love that's being presented with Sean in the director's seat, along with Joyce Pulitzer and Kitty Greenberg, a blessed memory, who had actually helped compose this. Yeah. And there we go. There's Alfred Richard. I wanted
There's
to mention
good old
that.
Alfred,
so
you know.
hopefully we'll be able to do them justice and let them know that we were thinking about them at least. Again, there's Carol, Claudia Baumgarten, and Alfred in the background. And I think you've got one more picture. There you go, there the whole group, and that's the film.
And once again, that's Sunday and then Thursday.
Right.
And you see the information, themelonsongs@gmail.com. But
right.
I'm looking forward to seeing it. I'm going to catch one of those performances. Thank you so much. And now back over to Poppy.
Well, everybody knows how I love the Crescent City Farmers Market. After all, I wrote the book almost 15 years ago. But I really wanted to remind everybody that now is the best time to shop at the market. Because in just a few weeks, it's going to be okra season, which means that's about all that there will be. But right now, oh my goodness, the Louisiana Gourmet Produce, which is my friend Tony Accardo, and wait till you see the farmer's daughter, his beautiful daughter, Aaliyah. He's been coming since she was just a twinkle in his eye. Tony's stuff is incredible, okay? Those sweet peppers he's holding in his hand, never tasted anything quite like them. He really specializes in heirloom strains, and he scooped me that coming up in the next couple weeks, there's going to be incredible heritage rare French melons. Oh my goodness, will they be good. Now there's Catherine Medair. She's one of the new farmers from Bread and Roses. Look at that beautiful boule. She just sold her first loaf a year ago. She's a pandemic product that has come out. And don't miss her cookies, her almond sugar cookies and chocolate cayenne. So then there's blueberries. The J&D blueberry guys are there with juice, popsicles, lemonade, and their Pearl River tea. Because believe it or not, you can grow tea in Mississippi.
Wow.
The figs are in. That is another big news flash. That only happens for a couple of weeks. So go to the market now. And the three markets that are around, and this will stay through the end of the year, I've been assured, that Stalwart Uptown Market from 8 till noon on Tuesday, and then on Thursdays on the Lafitte Greenway from 3 until 7. And Sunday, if you haven't been to the Sunday City Park Market, it's fantastic. They still have the drive-through feature where you can pre-order and drive through, and then from 10 until noon, it's a walk-up market. So the demos are getting ready to start again. They have an unlimited market match going on, dollar for dollar. Anybody who is on food stamps or what they call SNAP, you can a dollar for dollar match. That's a big money in your pocket.
Very good. Thank you so much, Poppy. And moving back over to John to talk about the other artists that are featured in that gallery that you had just mentioned.
Well, the Studio Waveland has a terrific new show. It's called #3D Mississippi. And this is the kind of show that Mitchell and Erica do so well. They're so popular in the New Orleans area, they're able to draw so many artists to their show. This contains 52 from the greater New Orleans area, including Southern Mississippi, 52 sculptors. And I've shown you, this is the interior of the gallery, which is, you know, really, it's a beautiful place. And I've shown you a few examples of some of the works in there, but it also contains works by people like Mark Grote, Sally Heller, Gene Koss, Steve Martin, Robert Tannen, and it goes on, 52 artists in total. So it's an eclectic show. It's a lot of fun to walk around and see these things and to interpret them. But keep in mind, if you want to visit the gallery, this is really a working studio for both Mitchell and Erica. So they're working in the studio. So the front of the gallery itself may not be open all the time. So they really suggest you call ahead and make an appointment to visit the gallery to make sure they're there so you can really enjoy seeing the work.
Okay.
And after demonstrations, too. She loves to give demonstration of how she welds this work she does.
All right.
So call ahead.
Very good. Thank you so much, John.
You're welcome.
And back over to Doug to talk about all this exciting national exposure for one local artist.
Huh. Andrew Lamar Hopkins is a star in the making. he's also a time traveler. He's one of those people who lives in the 21st century with the rest of us, but his head is in different eras.
He has always loved the early history of New Orleans. I met Hopkins when he was just 16 or 17 years old, when he was making miniature colonial furniture for museum shops. He has gone on to make what he calls 19th century folk art paintings of early New Orleans genre scenes. That's Marie Laveau there. Mm-hmm. He calls what he does Creole domestic life, especially the lives of the so-called free people of color in New Orleans from the pre-Civil War period. His view of the era is very idyllic. He has recently been discovered by the New York art scene and is bound to continue showing there. And his painting isn't his only art form. A few years back, Andrew began cross-dressing, and he considers his alter ego, Desiree Josephine de Planche, to be a 1950s Creole grand dame. That's what he says. And she's also a work of art. Desiree has, coincidentally, appeared at Poppy Tooker's drag brunches and in Poppy's book about drag brunches. That self-portrait of Andrew as Desiree is now in the National Gallery of Art.
Wow. Well, congratulations. And he has a very active Facebook. You can get a lot of information. And then he's also covered by Venus Over Manhattan, which is a Manhattan gallery. So congratulations to him, right?
Representing some big art stars.
Very good. Yeah. Thank you so much. And now back over to Alan for some other news.
Yeah, and I got my script in hand now, so no problem. Anyway, I just wanted to alert everybody about a fundraiser coming up this Sunday. And this is for the Open Call Theater Company. And they're going to have a cabaret fundraiser on Sunday night. And I'm mentioning this because this is the new company that's led by artistic and managing director Carol Eshelman. They'll be using the Gretna Cultural Center, the former post office, if you will, of the city of Gretna that was converted several years ago. And in regard to the use of that space and to help promote the Open Call Theater opening, I am going to be having a talk. It's actually already in the can, as it were, with the Honorable Mayor Belinda Constant, who was so lovely. And I urge everybody to watch all of what's happening, online, but to go on Sunday night, of course. So you'll be able to see everything for yourself Sunday night at the Gretna Cultural Center. They'll have, a cash bar and seats, I think, start at $20 for singles, and you can get tables if you want. But this will help them with some necessary funding.
And where are they located again?
They're located only a couple of blocks away off of Franklin. In the Gretna area, and the Gretna Cultural Center is right off of Huey Long Avenue, right in the heart of downtown Gretna. Mm-hmm. So you can't miss it. And again, what people will remember is the old post office. Mm-hmm. Also appearing at the Sunday night cabaret show that they're going to have is Anna E. St. John. So she's one of the stars. You'll want to go check her out. Of course, this is her as Lola Falana some years ago. Anaïs and Harry Marone have been entertaining in-person crowds and virtual gatherings over their weekly Porch Fest until recently. And they just received, for Porch Fest, a proclamation for the city of New Orleans acknowledging them for their work. Congratulations on that wonderful recognition. And so congratulations to Anaïs, who I've known really for a long time, ever since she was slinging drinks at Le Chat Noir. By the way, today is the 10th anniversary of the Le Chat Noir closing. And again, a sad day, but a day that was a night, if you will, of celebration with so many people who love that particular location. Again, the conversation about Open Call Theater Company will be held this Friday at 5 o'clock. You'll be able to see it on the NOLA Theater Folk Facebook group, theatercriticism.com's Facebook page, or my own YouTube channel. And a week from this Monday, on July the 19th, I will have many of the cast members of Jesus Christ Superstar on. Again, you'll be able to see it at the same spot. Don't forget to check that out as well. They should have a lot of fun there. And again, I'm really looking forward to seeing the show.
All right. Thank you so much. Now time for our picks of the week. Poppy.
Those guys at Koshan Butcher, they know how to have a good time. And they've just announced game night. Last night was the first one. It's not about Jeopardy. It's about wild game. Last night was duck. Next week it's rabbit, followed by wild boar. And the last Wednesday in July, it will be epic quail. So don't miss that yumminess. It's an a la carte menu. You're not like signing up for a whole big dinner.
All right. Thank you. John.
Well, after you see the sculpture show at Studio Waveland, just go up Coleman Avenue about a block to what they call Ground Zero. It's a little museum, very moving exhibits on the effects of Hurricanes Katrina on the Waveland area and the destruction it caused. There's also a traveling show there from the Smithsonian. It's called Exhibit on Rural America. Really well done. It's worth seeing.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you. And moving over to Doug.
You may have noticed it's gotten warm outside. And through July, Art and AC, on Sundays, you can go and see NOMA, the Ogden, and the CAC for free, thanks to the Hellis Foundation.
Yeah, that is such a good deal. Mm-hmm. Also, go to their website, because Louisiana Children's Museum and the Botanical Garden, there's also great deals of a few days each month, that those are a free admission as well. Thank you, Doug. And over to Alan.
Peggy, starting up this Sunday, Hadassah will be hosting a six-part series, a survey course, if you will, in Jewish music. And I'll be kicking it off with my own course on Broadway music, believe it or not, something I do have a little bit more than a passing knowledge of. So as Hadassah explores the world of Jewish music, it's free. The 6 weeks, you can see all of them together or take whichever ones you want. They're going to be on klezmer, choral music, liturgical music, jazz, and they're going to end with rock and roll and popular music. You can take any one of the courses, register on their Facebook page, and I will see you at the theater.
Thank you very much, Alan. And now my picks, Benny Grunch will be playing Sunday from 2 to 5 at the Carrollton Station, presented by the Town of Carrollton Watch.org, and that's right there at Carrollton on Willow. Excited about to hear that Benny's going to be playing. Chris Champagne, comedian, is presenting another performance of his new political satire show at Rock and Bowl. That's on Wednesday at 8 o'clock. You can order dinner if you come in at least by 6:30. Historic Peatod House Museum, located on Bayou St. John, has now reopened for tours. Go to peatodhouse.org for more information about that. Really, really exciting. It's a beautiful house. It's so interesting, too. And the grounds are intriguing. It's right there in the bayou. We just got news that Michael Cerveris, Kimberly Kay, and their band Loose Cattle will be playing this Sunday, July the 11th at 9 p.m. at DBA on Frenchman. And of course, that's great news. And then next Tuesday at 7 o'clock at the Maple Leaf on Oak Street. With a dollar of each ticket going to the New Orleans Musicians Clinic, advance tickets are available at Maple Leaf's website. Thank you all so much. It's great to see all of you, and thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.
Rouse's is proud of the creativity and the unparalleled entertainment in New Orleans, and honored to highlight it with their sponsorship of Steppin' Out on WYES.